Okay, parents and children, I've come back with the activity, but before I begin with the activity, I want to show the children a picture of a policeman. A policeman carries a baton for self-defense. See, you can see this. And on their belt, they have a walkie-talkie, which they use when they want to communicate with their team members and with the police station, people in the police station. So they also have a gun. They use it in situations when they are uncontrollable. So we'll go back to the activity. I'll keep this down now. So the activity is called fingerprinting activity. What we can do, parents, children can do, is just, you know, take a pencil and just keep doing this. And it'll be fun for them. And then they can press their fingers like this and make fingerprints. You can make it darker so that the fingerprints come well. So you can do it even with paints, but I preferred the pencil because it's more clean, less messier. So now why we are doing fingerprints is that policemen use fingerprints to trace the criminals. So if they walk into a house where there's a theft taken place, and if they find a fingerprint, based on the fingerprint, they give it to the detectives, and they can easily trace the criminal, because the fingerprints of two people are always unidentical. They are never the same, and that helps them to trace the criminal. Another thing we can make, parents, is a badge. All policemen have a badge, so just make a star like this and a little square and stick it with a number in it, and then the children can just hang it and have fun. The game that you can play with them is chore police at home. So you don't need anything over there, only the child hides. Either he's the chore or you the chore, and then, you know, it's a fun game that we have played in our childhood. So I'll come back with a song and I'll say bye now.